Dan told me that somebody that you're good friends with or you know quite well is the Dalai Lama.
I was in Tibet, and in Tibet I was a very famous monastery, Tsurpu, and from Tsurpu on I visited the Dalai Lama, for he invited me, for I made a record with the monks, you know, wow, with rhythm and monks and so.
When you met the Dalai Lama, what was that meeting like for you? I mean, did it inspire you in any way, or?
He inspired me a lot, just as a human being, first of all.
Yeah.
Second, he's a guy who can be very serious in one moment, and other moment he's very laughing, you know, and he has a lot of sense of humor. Yeah. For an example, I was there, and I set up, like what you are doing, a camera, I had a DAT recorder, everything there. And so I was there, I set up, everything was working fantastic. Dalai Lama came in, and we said hello, and at the moment that he came in, the DAT recorder stopped, complete nothing. So I looked at it, and he looked at me, and he said, "What's happening?" I said, "It's not working." And then he said, "Oh, okay, listen, in my youth, I was always repairing watches," he said, "when I was a kid." So, and he kneeled on the floor, I kneeled on the floor, you know, and he said, "Come, we start to repair that." And it was ridiculous, of course. So after 5-6 minutes, he said, "No, we give up." After that, he looked at me, he said, "You look very unhappy.
Aww.
You came from all over the world here and the thing is not working. You know what?" He said, "When you have time tomorrow, you come again at 10 o'clock in the morning, we do it again." I was thinking, shit, you know, I mean, the Dalai Lama is going all over the world, talking with kings and presidents, and then ask Chris Hinze if he has time. It's ridiculous. So I said, "Oh, thank you." So next day I came, it worked. And we did it again.
Mm.
And 2 years later, I visited him again, and he was very, very busy, and still he made time for me, about 20 minutes again. I gave him the records and things, you know, so that's the story about the Dalai Lama.
You've lived many, many years in Ibiza, and you had a recording studio here too.
Yeah.
How would you describe the island? How did it affect you, inspire you, and feed your soul?
Him here, I fell in love.
What made you fall in love with Ibiza?
Yeah, you cannot explain that. Ibiza is Ibiza. Even now, since there are so many tourists, in the summer there comes about 12 million tourists to Ibiza. It's not the Ibiza when I came here, but still, you know, I mean, still it is, yeah, it is amazing. It's a mystic island, you know.
I know. I realized that when I think about something, they say be careful what you manifest because it actually happens. And when I think, things happen very quickly.
Yeah.
So I have to watch my thoughts.
Now, yeah, I lived around. It was very funny. I lived around the corner and I had a big studio there. I sold the whole thing. And at the time that I had in mind to sell, somebody told me about Henry, so I gave him a call and said, "Listen, we are neighbors." He said, "Yes, come on." And so he came to my place. After that, I came here, so we became friends.